Hello, Gaylord. I'm Ethan Meliscus, and welcome to Across the Side Table. Today, my guest is Professor Thomas Patten.
Patten.
Is that correct?
No, Patten. Patten, like the general, but with an E-N.
Thomas Patten. He is a professor here at Gaylord. I actually took one of his classes, and I believe that I was your top student.
I have no memory of that.
Okay. I guess we'll dive in. Professor, what started your career in advertising? Were you not good at math?
Yeah, that's exactly it. Yes, it centered on my lack of math skills. I had done all kinds of things in college. I was a poetry major, so that, you know, logically from that I became a commercial fisherman. I was a poetry major in Kansas, and so I became a commercial fisherman in Rhode Island. An ad agency had mercy on me and my dumb book of poetry that I showed them, gave me a few projects, and that launched it. First job was at a veterinary specialty agency in Kansas City, and from there I've been like a journeyman copywriter. I went to Portfolio Center, and from there put an actual book together and eventually ended up in Portland, Oregon.
Yeah, well, I don't eat fish. I think it's...
Yeah, neither do I. I've seen them. Okay. Yeah, I've talked to them.
So now, going into your ad career, what, I mean, did you do anything cool?
No. Yeah, if you've seen my book, there's nothing cool in there.
And so now, with being a professor here, did you just want to prove to kids that you were better than them at advertising?
Yes, yes. That's really been the motivating factor in my career, is to be better than other people. Mm. No, the opportunity came, my wife found the job. There was a job announcement, so she was wanting me to get out of advertising. So this is tangential, and this is where my father went to university, and you know, my grandfather moved to Norman when it was just a cow town. So it was a pretty comfortable, easy move for us.
And so can you explain, obviously I had your class before, can you explain to maybe students who...
It's not obvious to those who have seen your book.
Okay. Could you explain to maybe prospect students or students who are already in Gaylord who are getting ready to get into your class, what exactly they're going to look forward to?
The advertising storytelling class, we introduce them to different medias and writing for different medias. We sort of concentrate on the basics, good heavy 5 weeks, on the basics of coming up with ideas. And I really hammer home the art of the headline at that point. And then we move on to other media, and so we're in interactive, social, ambient, a little bit of TV and radio as well. So each week is a different challenge for them. Each week they submit something, it gets critiqued, and I hope to see some improvements based on the critique, as I hoped with you. Improvement through the critiques.
I guess we'll move on. What helps you sleep at night? Are you a melatonin guy?
Yes, melatonin, a fair amount of alcohol, Aquavelva, whatever I've got around. Mm. Yeah.
And are you a morning person?
I'm not sure. I don't know the answer to that question. It depends on the morning. Probably this morning I was not. So.
Yeah, I'm not either. And I'm starting to regret having to get up for this.
Could have scheduled this afternoon, but this is fine.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So if an incoming freshman, if say you were to meet one, what advice would you give them on ensuring that they have the best time they possibly could at Gaylord and soak in the most information possible?
Well, there's lots of organizations, but you do have to be sort of self-motivated, right? So as curious and hungry as you are is how much information you'll get. I only have 3 hours a week with you. But I got office hours, got plenty of time. We could, if you're really hungry, we could pick up side projects. There's organizations to join. There's Ad Club. There's Lindsay and Asp, the in-house agency that's run by students. So there's lots of things going on, as well as peer relationships. There's some social things going on as well. But as the movie said, demented and sad, but social.
And so, say, for a senior like me who's getting ready to go off into the real world,
what, for example,
what would you tell me as some advice?
Well, we'd sit down with your book, and then I'd try to pretend to be somebody interested in you for a position at my agency.
Ha ha, ha ha, ha ha, ha. If someone were to offer you $5 million right now to quit your job, would you do it?
Yes.
Money is way more important than the fulfillment of students' legacies.
Yes.
Professor, thank you so much.
Yes, it is. It's not happening.
And that wraps up our segment of Between the Side Table, or Outside the Side Table.
The other side of the side.
The flip side of the side table.
The near side of the side table.
Two guys on leather seats on opposite sides of a side table.
One kind of
with legs crossed.
Straight forward.
Look, I didn't prep as much for this as you seem to have. I'm so sorry, Professor.
But you're super comfortable and natural.
Yeah,
I like how you're riffing.
These jeans are flexible.
They are, oh, they have a little flex in them?
Yeah.
Yeah, I like the boots, too.
I'm sorry, I didn't bring my corduroys.
Yeah. No, well, you know, it's a rainy day. I thought I'd push it. It's way past Easter, so I probably shouldn't be wearing corduroys. In Tillamook, hold your hands like that and turn them. This was the... In Tillamook, Oregon, that's the handshake.